frustration. I'm trying to slow down my speaking because, first of all, I filmed this video like 8 times, right? And I keep either getting interrupted, or my phone dies, or my alarm go off. And okay, so I've turned off my alarms. I have turned off my internet and all that. And I'm hoping that I don't get a knock on my door anymore. Because I'm ready to be done with it. I have not been on YouTube in a long time. Hello, welcome back. I didn't say welcome back. I'm sorry. Welcome back, y'all. I appreciate y'all for hanging in there, waiting on me. But I want to talk about something that nobody's talking about, and I'm so, y'all see, I'm into it. I'm speaking too fast. And nobody is talking about, and that people should be talking about, WandaVision on Disney Plus. That show is so good. Now, I'm gonna share my, because I don't know anybody that watches the show. All I see is like TikToks about it. Like, y'all know, I have to do hashtag WandaVision to find stuff about it. So, like, I can get stuff from a different perspective. Like, maybe find some things that I've never seen. Like, you know, see some things that I might have missed when I was watching. So, if y'all intend on watching the show, do not watch this video because spoiler alert is gonna be full of spoilers. I'm just gonna be basically telling y'all a whole episode, cause y'all, that third episode was so crazy. So I'm gonna try to slow down my speaking and collect my thoughts. But so WandaVision, you got Wanda and Vision from like the Marvel's movies and stuff, like from Endgame, all Age of Ultron, you know, Autumn. And they have their own show. So the show premiered, I think, January 15th or whatever the last Friday was in January. And they dropped 2 episodes, the premiere and then like another episode, I guess, to get us hooked. And now it's just coming out every Friday, like a TV show, like a real TV show every Friday. And I think they're doing that so we still, so we don't, so we can wait for Falcon and Winter Soldier because that comes out March 19th. Think about it. If it's coming out like a TV show every Friday, it's probably going to lead us into February or March. So basically, to keep us on the hook of the Marvel Universe until Falcon and Winter Soldier come out, which I am so excited for. I'm sorry if I'm talking too fast, but now that's the movie I'm waiting for. But yeah, back to WandaVision. So this, it's like a real TV show, like, and cinematically, I think I'm using that right, like the movie style or the show style. It's like when they go in between certain scenes, it goes from like the square frame, you know, like some TV shows have, to wide, like a movie. And I like that. Just that's just a hint that you can watch if you like go through. You see my little spaceman? I like this. I got some tapestry. But I'll show y'all, I'll give y'all a room tour because I just redid my whole room. But anywho, yeah. What was I saying? Dang, spaceman got me distracted. Yeah, they got a TV show and it changed. So yeah, that's really cool that you can watch when you go like when you see it, you can be like, oh, that's neat. Like, and they use that to differentiate between certain, like basically you could tell like, oh, this is different from this scene. Like it's different places, different times really, if you think about it. But yeah. So first episode, like first, I think the first 1 or 2 episodes was in black or was in black and white. And then they got color and stuff, like TV start out in black and white and then color. And basically they move into this new town and they got their superpowers. They know they got their superpowers, but they try to act normal. So the people in this town have no prior knowledge, or they should have no prior knowledge of Iron Man, Captain America, Wanda, or Vision. Like, you know, like nothing that has to do with any of that. They should know nothing, right? That's how it's set up. So they move there and they like Wanda got her cooking and cleaning, and Vision got his job. And like they're living a normal life going through the decades, right? So I think at the end of one episode, we figure out that Wanda's pregnant, right? So she's pregnant with twins, but we didn't know that yet. And they didn't know that yet. So the episode 3, that she, like, it was centered around the pregnancy. So, like, the pictures, her powers, she got the pictures on the wall spinning, the faucets is going crazy, the power went out in the whole town. So basically, her, you can tell her powers have a lot of influence over what goes on in the scenery, right? So she, they're playing some jams outside my door. But anywho, yeah, so she controls some scenery and stuff with her emotions and all that. So she, I'm gonna try to tell y'all this in order because every time I tell it on camera and I go back and watch it, I'm like, they will not be able to understand. So they found out that Wanda's pregnant. Vision went to go get the doctor. The doctor come to their house. He like, oh, good thing y'all got me while y'all could, because I'm about to go on vacation out of town. Right? Right. So, and everything that I'm saying like this is important. So he got the doctor. The doctor said he's gonna go out of town later that day. Lucky you got me while you could. And this is the beginning, the very beginning of Wanda's pregnancy. But somehow she had all three trimesters, the whole pregnancy experience in one day. And so she went from like the little belly to having the big belly in a day. So keep that in mind. While all this is going on, like in the middle of the show, there's a neighbor named Herb. Their neighbor, the next door neighbor. He's sitting here, y'all know how, like, you know, the suburban life, you trim your hedges, make them real nice, trim your bushes. And he wasn't trimming a bush, he was trimming a fence. Like he was cutting through the fence, literally cutting through the fence. And Vision go outside, he like, you okay? He like, yeah, what, like, you know, acting like everything all cool, hunky dory, cool and stuff, like. So then Vision like, okay, that's weird, but okay. So he go about his business, I guess. And then later in the scene and stuff, Vision about to go somewhere and Herb is there cutting the fence again, like still cutting the fence. But then they got another neighbor that he talking to, and I forget her name. We gonna call her Susan. So Susan, she talking to Herb and like whispering and all that. So the Vision go over there because he's still cutting the fence. So he like, what's up, y'all? Like, I love Vision in this show. Like, he is doing, and the actor that played him, I think his name was like Paul Bettany or something like that. He's doing so good. You're doing an amazing job, sir. Like, you're just so convincing. And, like, you're like us. Like, I feel like he is along with the audience. Like, some of the stuff he think is what we thinking. You know, like, he's that character. But, yeah, so he walk over to them and he like, what's up? And then they're like, oh, nothing, da da da. And then the lady like, oh, is Geraldine in your house? That's Wanda's friend who was indeed in the house. She's like, oh, is Geraldine in your house? And Vision like, yeah, da, 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 I guess. And she was like, don't you think she's odd? And y'all know, like, that's like a big thing in their town, I guess, is not being odd, being perfect, kind of. So she's like, don't you think she's kind of odd? He's like, how so? It's like, she doesn't have a home. He's like, well, she doesn't have a home. And they're like, yeah, no home, no family, no nothing. But mind you, Geraldine is in the house with Wanda telling her about how she just got a promotion and this, that, and the third, and all that other good stuff. So then Vision like, what you mean? But then the girl Susan, like, she just went off. But then or she was about to leave, but then Herb was saying something like, well, you know, the people here are a little, like, he was about to say something like that's wasn't supposed to be said yet. So then the girl Susan, she like, shh, you're not supposed to say nothing. You're not supposed to say. Now, Susan, now the lady, I need to figure out her name because she's a strange character as it is. I don't trust her because she seemed like she know a little bit more than she's supposed to too. Like, that's like Wanda's best friend in the show, I guess. Like, she was like the first person to come to their house when they moved to the town. She was like being nice, brought them, like helping her out and stuff, adjust to the town. So that's like her friend. But she off to me, something off. She know too much. She do too much. She know too much and she do too much. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but she does. She don't sit right with me. So Wanda is in a house with the lady Geraldine that day that the neighbors was calling odd because she has no home, or family or whatever. So Geraldine in the house with Wanda. Wanda, she tried to hide her babies from the friend Geraldine because she was like, you know, like, if I'm your friend and I've been seeing you these past couple days and weeks and you haven't been this big and pregnant, something's off. Something's odd, you know? So Wanda went into labor while it was just her and Geraldine in the house, right? So Geraldine was like, that's weird, but okay. Like, you know, she just brushed it off and she was like, okay, we're gonna deliver these babies, or this baby, because they didn't know it was twins yet. She's like, I'm gonna deliver this baby. And I guess Wanda, or what's her name, Vision, went to go get the doctor, right? And the doctor was about to leave for vacation when he went to go get him, and he was like, I can't even get my car to start, my car messing up, and da da da, but I'm gonna come help you, right? Vision ran him to the house, but okay, they came back and Geraldine delivered a baby, right, for Wanda. One got the baby, and then it turned out to be twins, right? So then it's like two big parts that I need to, you know, to pay attention to. So the first part is with, I'll tell the doctor. The doctor said when they got to the house, they was too late. They already delivered the baby. Vision and the doctor was too late. So the doctor was like, oh, good thing you got me while you could. I was about to leave, you know. And then he couldn't start his car. And then he said, you'll find it hard. Or he would say something like, oh, that's okay. Like, I'm not missing out on it. You'll find it hard to leave small towns. He said something like that, basically implying that they can't leave that town. So I'm like, ooh, what's going on? So he knew that he wasn't going to be able to leave, but he... Take that as y'all may, but I know I took that as that they cannot leave. They don't, like... They're there. They're not there against their will, but like if they wanted to leave, they can't. So keep that in mind. That's gonna go into my overall theory. Okay. So then back with Geraldine and Wanda. They rocking the babies and stuff in a crib or whatever. They watching the babies in the crib. And then, you know, Wanda had the twin Pietro from Age of Ultron who died because Hawkeye was holding the baby boy, was holding the boy. He was like, all right, I'm gonna take this bullet for this little boy, you know. But then Quicksilver took the Pietro, Wanda's brother, took the bullet for him. If y'all don't, first of all, go back and watch Age of Ultron, because I watched that and that movie is so good. Like, I'm gonna do a video review on all Marvel movies and ranking them, because I didn't know that I liked Age of Ultron as much as I did. Like, I rewatched that for my birthday, which was the 19th. And it was so good. Like, the comedy, the vibes, the everything about Age of Ultron was so good. So, I don't know. But we're going to talk about that later. So, in that movie is when Pietro, Wanda's twin brother, died. Right? Like I said, in the town, there's no way that any of them know about Iron Man, Captain America, da-da-da. And I'm going to explain why certain stuff. Just hold on. So, y'all see I have to sit up. It's getting serious. So, Wanda is looking at the twins like, oh, I had a twin once. Like, you know, having a loving moment. Like, I had a twin once. His name is Pietro. And then Geraldine is like, oh, the one that got killed by Ultron? And then Wanda's like, because, like, she's not supposed to know that. She like, what you just say? And then Geraldine like, oh, I'm just talking about how strong of a woman you are for having those babies. And she was like, no, what did you just say? Repeat that for me one more time. Like, and she wasn't trying to say it again. But basically, next thing you know, y'all know how I said you can't leave the town? Geraldine left the town. And I'm going to connect this. It's like, it's too good. Let me calm myself down. So, Geraldine left the town. And I'll tell y'all how in a minute. But then Vision came back home, talking to Wanda, and then Vision like, oh, where did Geraldine go? And guess what Wanda said? Wanda said, Geraldine went home. Now remember the people was talking and was like, she don't have no home? Okay, now time for me to connect it and tell y'all my theory. So my theory is that this town that they moved to live a normal life or whatever is really, because Vision is dead. Vision is dead. Correct me if I'm wrong. Vision is dead. Got the stone ripped out of his head. I think that Wanda is controlling. She put people in a town, or she took over a small town and is controlling their reality. Y'all know how her powers is control the reality of the people. So they live in her fantasy, living a normal life with Vision. So they're doing things like participating in neighborhood stuff, like the neighborhood watch, like the girl, you know, the girl groups like they used to have like in the 50s, like selling Tupperware, throwing pool parties and talent shows and all that. And I haven't seen any children in the show now that I think about it besides Wanda's. Maybe I'm just missing something, but let me know. Actually, I'm going to go rewatch the 3 episodes and see if I see any children, because I don't think any children pop up until we see Wanda's twins. That's weird. Look at me putting stuff together. See, my phone about to die again. But, okay, so let me tie this all together real fast. So, I think she created, like, the dome. She has a dome around the town so nobody can get out and nobody can get in without her making it happen. So Geraldine, she didn't leave. Wanda threw herself, she threw her out the dome because she know too much, because she said too much, you know? And I seen somebody on TikTok say that their theory was that her pregnancy, Wanda's pregnancy, messed with some of the stuff. So like I said, she had the pitcher spinning and a faucet going and the power out in the whole town because of her pregnancy. It's because she couldn't focus. Y'all know how she, I said she's controlling it. She couldn't quite focus on all that other stuff because she was pregnant. She couldn't focus. Like, and then like the scenery in the third episode was weird the whole time, right? So I think she couldn't focus on, like, you know, putting as much detail into the scene. She couldn't focus on making Herb not cut the fence. Like, that was weird because she couldn't focus, because she couldn't control it. You know what I'm saying? That, I think that's good. Like, that's it. And she couldn't block that memory. Like, okay, so think about it. If there was a small town and all the stuff that had just went down in Endgame and da-da-da had just happened, of course everybody know about that. Everybody know about Wanda. Everybody know about Pedro. Da-da-da. So the people in the town might have known about Iron Man and stuff before Wanda got there and, like, you know, was controlling their minds. But the way that she has it set up, they're not supposed to know nothing like that. So maybe her pregnancy affected, like, how Geraldine knows stuff. So Geraldine knew about Pedro and that he died by Ultron. So she had to go. She got kicked out. Oh, and the doctor, like I said, he couldn't leave, but Geraldine got kicked out. So without her making, you know what I'm saying? I hope I told y'all that good, because I don't even have enough time to film this again. Like, I'm not even going to edit this. I'm just going to put it out there. But yeah, so final thoughts about it. I'm really excited to see where this go. Like, beyond excited. Like, I'm so ready. And some weird things that have happened, when the show was in black and white, the only things that were, like, in color, there was a helicopter in the front bush of Wanda and Vision's house. Now, what I think this came from is the helicopter outside of the dome. I don't know. But basically, it was like one thing in color while the rest of the show was in black and white. So I found that strange. And then one of the women in the neighborhood cut her hand and it was red blood. So, like, stuff that she couldn't control can be in color. Like, that she wants, like, you know. And then there's a radio. Like, there's probably a radio somewhere. Or, like, if there was a radio where it was by this pool or something. I don't know. I'm not explaining this good. But it always be like, it's be somebody from the outside, the FBI. It was like, Wanda, who's doing this to you? Wanda, da da. Like, trying to get her attention from the outside. She could hear that, but, like, she's ignoring it. You just really gotta watch. Like, I'm not a good speaker. I'm not a good explainer. So you need to go watch this for yourself and really, really look at stuff. Like, there's Easter eggs, hints and stuff in every episode. Like, it's so deep. Like, it's so, it goes deep. Like, but it killed me when Wanda said that Geraldine went home after they just told Vision she has no home. I'm like, you're not gonna speak up, bro? Like, you know, maybe she controlled his mind to not say nothing because, and it was a point in time where Vision said, like, something feels off of, something don't feel right, sweetheart. Something don't feel good about, you know, you have to admit something feels odd. And she rewinded time and made him say something else. So, I think she controlling the whole dome. She controlling people's minds. She controlling this. She controlling that. And bottom line, watch the show for yourself. I'm so excited for this Friday to see what they got going on. Because I think last we left off, yeah, it was when she said, oh, Geraldine went home. And then Geraldine, when she got kicked out the dome, it was all the FBI right there. They had the guns pointed at her. Had the spotlight on her. So they probably gonna have her question. Like, I'm just too excited. It's like every episode is something up in the air for you to figure out for the next episode. Like, it's so good. So every Friday, Disney Plus, I need y'all to watch. I need y'all to share y'all theories with me. I need y'all to let me know if I missed anything. I don't know. I did miss a lot because I don't know. Filming multiple times is not good because then you can't remember. Oh, did I say that this video or the last video? Thank y'all for listening to me ramble about the show. But y'all should really go watch. Like, it's already 10 out of 10, and it's only been 3 episodes. Have a blessed day. Have a blessed evening. If y'all gotta go to work like me, I hope you have a good day at work. I appreciate y'all. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Like I said, please let me know your theories. I'm, like, so invested in this show. Like, but y'all have a good day. And stay positive until next time. That's what I was trying to remember. Stay positive until next time. Like I said, I have not been here in a long time, but...